What's up, man?
What's up, man? I watched your video.
Guys, say hi. What's your name, man?
Rodney.
Guys, say hi to Rodney. He is one of the best resellers that I've seen in recent area, in this area. Rodney, say something to my viewers.
Gotta watch out for this guy. Whatever advice he gives you to go shopping and buy stuff, stay away from the Goodwills and stay away from the Salvation Armies. It's all junk, no good stuff.
Exactly, guys. He is telling the truth. All you guys that have like crazy dreams about finding stuff, this guy will find it before you.
Like this, we'll see. Hold on.
Like this typewriter. Look at this, guys. This actually goes for $10,000. I checked the comps.
Ready?
I already checked.
Did you?
So $175.
Yeah.
Of course, yeah.
But the solds.
Guys,
there's not a lot of solds.
Rodney will pick this up and he'll repair it. I checked it. I plugged it in.
It
doesn't work properly. It's making a humming noise. So it has to be serviced. And it's $20. And it's making a humming noise. I don't know how to test it, but you can sell it for parts. For $175.
I don't know if it's worth my time.
But Rodney here, he'll make sure it works before he sells it. Hello guys, decided to do a little voiceover on a short clip from my local Goodwill. I actually picked up this DVD-VCR combo in the beginning, and then I tested it out, it didn't work properly, so I left it. Yeah guys, those can bring good money if you find them working with remote control especially. So yeah, I actually was testing it. I think VHS side didn't work on it. In a toy section here, I don't remember if I actually specifically got something right away at this particular time, but I know at that particular day I did pick up some things. You'll see it later, so stay tuned please guys. You will see me pick up different types of items to resell. So, and I got help from other resellers also at the same time finding some stuff, so thank you guys. Whoever's one of the resellers that is watching my videos all the time, I know who you are, guys. So thanks, guys. Yeah, the thing is, this was actually also, I think, over 2 weeks ago. I'm lagging with my footages, but I will find stuff. Decided just to show you some stuff that was currently, that day on the shelves. As you can see, there's the usual stuff as in any other day. I always like to check this section with different figures. Most of the times they're broken. Something is either missing or they're cracked. So I have to look very carefully at them because when they're on the shelves, you have to make sure you find the one that is not broken or not missing a piece or missing something from it. But most of the time they're not valuable. Sometimes you'll find one here or there that's valuable. This stuff I actually decided to leave. I actually was kind of debating on picking up all this tape that you see. This is proprietary tape for setting up on the floor to keep the distance away. Different color tapes that you see in hospitals or any other office buildings. Actually, on Amazon, it was selling for good money, I think, for $30. And they wanted, $7 for a smaller size and $12 or $15 for a bigger size tape, like in terms of inches. So I actually picked up, put it in my cart, and then I left it. The thing is, I decided it was worth too much at Goodwill. Maybe I would have gotten it cheaper if I talked to the manager, but I didn't. And I was sorting a little bit through clothing. Didn't find anything in terms of clothing that day, I think. Maybe I did. I don't remember, guys. Sorry. But you'll see everything in my footage later on, so stay tuned. Until the end, please, you'll see my finds. And I had some fun that day, actually. I checked the footage. There were different fun things. I talked to other resellers at that day. So guys, stay tuned, please. and thanks for watching this clip.
Alright guys, I just brought out new cart at Goodwill. Look, there is nothing. There are some weights, orange weights, which can bring some money for $3.59. If you guys think I should pick them up, put the comments down. But everything else, look at this. Pens, flowers, mostly unnecessary stuff. So guys, see what we have to deal with here. Alright guys, Rodney here helped me out. Here's Rodney. Helped me out pick out the skateboard. It's pretty good. For $3.59. Rodney, appreciate it, man. Next time I'll find something for you, man.
Find something. I know what this is.
Okay guys, here's Rodney's find today. Look at that. He found something which cost probably $10,000.
How much is this thing?
What is it? A car seat?
Yeah, it's like a seat cushion. I better not tell him what it's worth. Can I find out how much this is? It was sitting right here.
Oh,
okay.
There was no price yet, but we're gonna wait for the price, guys. Rodney may have found a pot of gold. He always has a good eye on things, guys. If you meet him somewhere, look at that.
Hold on. See what they're selling for. I've sold these before.
Not bad.
$70.
Yeah, good job. See, guys, that's the life of resellers. Especially Rodney, who has another job. He has another job, guys. He's a part-time, but he does a great job of having a great eye on finding things. So Rodney did a good job so far.
Hey guys, this is Roman back with you, and I left Goodwill, and today was not a bad haul actually. Again, the whole week actually, starting this week, was kind of good in terms of different things I was able to find at my local Goodwill. I didn't make a footage for you guys from previous Goodwills that I went to, another one, not the local ones that I usually go to. But there wasn't much stuff that I found there at all, so there was nothing special basically. But today I just want to share with you guys the haul of the stuff that I found at my local Goodwill, which was not bad. And I would like to thank one of the resellers and pickers that usually goes to my Goodwill. His name is Steve, and he's kind of like old, very professional, very good picker, old school. And he found a figurine today that he gave to me. It's not like huge money, but I really appreciated it. But I told him to watch the channel, but he said that he doesn't watch YouTube, and he's one of those older generation people. They are not into that kind of stuff, like me and most of you resellers guys are just people younger generation that watch YouTube and watch other channels, like social media, like Facebook or Instagram, because most people now, especially younger generations, they are all using this type of social media. So, but anyway, guys, let me share with you what I found today. Okay, first thing is this vintage Panasonic. It's a radio tape cassette. It's like a cassette player here. You can see it opens up. Radio is here, and there is like a cool display here. It's not like really one of those really vintage looking ones in terms of display, but still it has a good nice look to it. And you see here it's model RQ437S, made in Japan. Didn't check the battery compartment here, but it looks clean. Actually in a very good condition, guys. It came with a power cord. I was able to actually plug it in and test it, and it works. The radio works absolutely fine. No issues whatsoever. I checked both FM, AM, and the volume control, everything. As you can see, the knobs here, the volume knob and tone, radio switch to tape, to sleep, And those are, of course, as you know, tape control buttons here. I inserted the, actually the tape, which I carry with me to Goodwill. And most resellers, of course, know, most of you guys sometimes would take carry the cassette with you to the thrift store or garage. Well, not garage sale, of course, because most of the time at the garage sale, unless the owner will let you plug it in, most of the time they are so cheap over there that you just purchase it, so you don't test it. But at Goodwill, there is an opportunity to test it connected to power, of course, with their power outlet and power strip, which they provide. And I plugged it in with a cassette tape, which I have, and it did work. The only issue here is a button, as you can see. The forward button is not staying in. Rewind button works. Play button also works. Eject works, as you can see here. But forward button, I don't know. I have to do more research. You know, sometimes those older vintage radios with cassette players built in, they had this kind of option where you had to hold the button down with a fast forward, but I'm not sure, maybe I'm wrong. You can leave comments if I'm wrong about it, maybe not. I don't know, but I'll research it. And also my friend who does electronics repair, I will be able to take it to him so he can look at it and determine if it's one of those issues with the button itself, it's like a spring, or it's supposed to be like that. So, and it has a carrying handle too, which is really nice. You can carry it with you. It's not that heavy, and has like a TV, tuning wheel here. It has some other switches right here, and has, I think, antenna is right here, as you can see. So, yeah, that was a good pickup. It was $4.49, as you see here. So yeah, this was not a bad pickup. It's not huge money. I checked the comps. They sell for around $39.99. I saw one for parts for $50, not in a working condition. I didn't see sold comps like that were available. I have to check Terapeak to see if there were this model sold previously in the past and how much it was. So, but for $4, I usually pick them up. Especially in this kind of clean condition, it's worth it in my opinion. Most of you probably will agree with me. I'll show you some clothing items. I told you previously in the past in my videos I stopped dealing with clothing, but I started again, and hopefully I'll continue, because previously in the past I had some luck with some brands which sold fast. Some stuff is laying around for a while. That's the only thing that I didn't like about selling clothing, is that it's like long tail. You have to find proper buyer for specific design, specific brand, specific size, specific material. So, but anyways, this stuff actually sells faster. This is a Vineyard Wines long sleeve shirt. It's Murray shirt, 100% cotton. And it was really clean. Somebody even took it to the dry cleaner. And see the Vineyard Wines, a whale here. So it's really clean. It was cleaned, so I don't have to do much stuff with it. I have to just maybe take photos and list it. That's all. Another thing with clothing that I didn't like. You have to take photos, you have to measure stuff, show the measurement, and takes a little bit longer in terms of listing the clothing items for me. Shoes are the same, but with shoes they bring more profit, of course. That's why I don't mind listing shoes compared to like shorts or sweaters or, well, jackets. It's different. If I find a good brand of the jacket with good size, they can bring more money too. But this one was $4.59, and it's not bad for Vineyard Wines. I can still sell, put, I mean, list it for around $24.99, maybe even more plus shipping. So, not a bad pickup for $4.59. Okay, next one is also Vineyard Wines. It's a polo shirt, same price. Size large, $4.59. It's a button top or front. There's a whale here, the pocket right here. And long sleeve, It's a striped pattern, as you see. So it's not bad. I mean, still, I check the comps, they go for around $19.99 plus shipping. This color maybe $24.99 because it's kind of a burgundy black type color. So it also depends what type of color on in clothing. So some people like more popular, they like design, like graphics and stuff like that. Okay, next clothing item, guys, is this. It's a Patagonia shirt. It's short sleeve. Also was a, it's like a plaid stripe pattern. This was $4.59, same price as Vineyard Wines, size large. It's like, you know, for the summer, which is a spring, upcoming summer, I think it's pretty good right now to list it because it's like really light. And I actually wanted to keep it for myself, but I wear extra large, so probably will not fit into it. Maybe I will already, I lost weight. So the thing is, yeah, with this type of, with those types of brands, this Patagonia short can also go for around, hopefully for $19.99 plus shipping, maybe even a little bit more, but size-wise, it matters too. If it was extra large or 2XL, it would go for more money, because those are more kind of, in terms of clothing, shorts and polo shorts, t-shirts, if you find size extra large, double XL or triple XL, they can go for better money than size large or medium. So, and I've noticed that in the past. Now, next thing that I found was, this is actually not bad, in my opinion. This is called Kaplan Medical Anatomy Flashcard, 3rd edition. And this brand new sealed in a box for $3.39. They, on eBay, I didn't see a lot of sold comps. Some were there, different edition, sold for $9.99 plus shipping and stuff like that. But on Amazon, they go for better money. I checked the Amazon because I can sell this on Amazon, and they go for around $34.99. And there were, I think, maybe one person selling it right now on Amazon, so I can list it even higher than $34.99 with either free shipping or like plus shipping. Which I, on Amazon, usually I have, I usually set it up so, in terms of like product which is available, because on Amazon, if there are a lot of people who have this product and Amazon has it, you cannot like compete in terms of the actual price. You can list it for the higher price, but it's not gonna sell, even though the rank may be good. So when you only have like a couple people selling the same product, it's much better because you can list it at your own price and this is going to sell if someone is looking for it. So I think it's, I will list it on Amazon and also on eBay. So it, I will see, as I usually do on both platforms, to see where it's going to sell faster. So, but it's not bad. It was $3.39. So I'll make some money on Amazon if it sells. I think it's going to sell on Amazon because I sold this kind of thing on Amazon in the past and it sold fast. Okay, next couple of items are kind of low. I mean, maybe actually not bad. I'll show it to you. First thing is this NASA triangle. All right, guys. Next item was actually the one that I got, that was given to me by another picker, Steve. Unfortunately, he's not watching YouTube, as I told you previously. He is one of the older generation type of people that they don't like to watch YouTube channels or any type of social media type of things like Instagram or Facebook. So, but anyway, he actually gave me this figure, and this is the figure here. This is, I think it's Roy Lee or Ray Lee, who is the artist or the maker, handmade probably. I think it's handmade. It's a limited edition type of figure. It's a clown, policeman. That's what it's called. It's like, in terms of the height, I think it's 8 inches height, high and like 4 inches wide. But yeah, it's pretty cool. It's like, this is marble, some kind of metallic mesh here on a marble stand. And it's made from metal, I think. I am not sure. Some kind of hard ceramic, but I don't think it's a ceramic. It's I found the comps for it on eBay. They don't go for like huge money, but I got Steve actually got it first, and it was $3.39, but he found it today on a new cart, and when they brought out new cart with new things, and he just I talked to him, and he decided just to give it to me. He said that I can have it and try to sell it. So thanks, Steve. Thank you, Steve. Of course, I hope you're gonna watch. I told him to subscribe to my channel, but he's not gonna watch YouTube, he said. So unfortunately, he's a very cool guy. He's actually featured in one of my videos, which I think I'll put the link down below in this video for that video where you will see Steve. It's one of those old school type of pickers. And he comes to Goodwill constantly, and he will just pick out some stuff. He doesn't grab a lot of stuff. He's one of those pickers that just looks for something really special that can bring like a lot of money. And unfortunately, at Goodwill nowadays, with the structure that Goodwill has, most stuff that they get, if it's something really valuable, it doesn't get to the floor. It basically, they put it up on their website and just sell it on their website. And that's what's been happening last at least couple years, I think. But stuff that sometimes some stuff will slip through the cracks and it will get to the floor. But it's really rare right now. I mean, it doesn't happen often. That's what I can tell you. But anyway, yeah, that's a pretty cool figure. It's heavy. It's like paperweight. It's kind of heavy. I think it's like maybe 3 pounds by itself without a box. So, but the comps I checked, they don't go for great money. There are some listed for I think $89, maybe $99, but they haven't sold. So I can list it for the same price and just wait for the right buyer. And of course, as you know, those types of things, they require this special buyer that looks for this kind of stuff, that collects this kind of stuff. So that's important. And that's why when you price it, it's a long tail item. And you have to wait for that special buyer to get it eventually. That may be in your stock for a while, maybe a year, maybe even more. But if you price it lower, of course, it may sell faster. But I will not try to sell it faster. I'll just list it for higher price and wait for that special buyer. Right, guys, and now to the big boys, kind of big boy finds. Okay, first, there are two things. One is electronics, one is shoes. Okay, here they are. The shoes are, this is a very good brand, guys. Be on the lookout for this brand. The brand is Crockett & Jones. And it's made in England. So it's like a leather. And look at the condition, it's excellent. It was $7.89, but they're like in mint condition. It's like maybe they were not even worn. Unfortunately, there is some kind of wear right here in the back, but I'll have to disclose it. And see, this one doesn't have it, but this one does, some kind of blemish here. But overall, they are like brand new. Like, I don't think they were worn. Maybe there are some blemishes here, but those shoes, there are comps. I didn't find those specific ones, I have to look, but it didn't matter because when I checked the comps in the beginning for this brand, I knew this brand. It's really rare that I find. I only found it once before. It's so rare that I find it at Goodwill, this Crockett & Jones brand of shoes. If you find it, guys, they can go up to around $400. I'm not kidding. If they're brand new, they can go even higher. I've checked some comps. There were some that were close to $500 per pair. But it all depends on the style, depends on the size, depends on what type. Like, those are loafers, slip-on. There may be Oxford ones that go for better money, but looking at the comps, you just pick it up. It's gonna sell for great money. I'm pretty sure about that because this brand sells good. It's very specific, unique. Some people only buy this kind of brand. It's very good I mean, very good quality. So be on the lookout for the Crockett and Jones brand shoes. They can bring very good money, guys. And for $7, I think when I found them, as you see, the soles are like, I mean, I don't know if they were worn or clean, like entirely clean. I would not have to even clean them. They're made in England. And yeah, guys, this is a size 8.5. And as you can see, leather upper lining. And yeah, here's made in England. So they're real. They're not fake, for sure. Because sometimes you find shoes at Goodwill that may be fake, and you will be able to tell it's a fake. Or as we call it, Fugazi in Italian. But those are not fake, for sure. I'm pretty sure. I mean, 100% sure they're not. I mean, they're like label, like branded on the soles, and you can see the on the actual, on the inside here, on the insoles and stuff like that. So this is for sure real. So they can go for great money, guys. So that was great find. Thank you, Goodwill, for that find. And last item I'll share with you guys. This is also really good find. Very rare. Okay, here it is. It's Technics CD compact disc player. It's a SL P500 model. And it's one disc. But this is a rare model, guys. I checked the comps for this model, and the last two that sold in month of February of this year, they sold for $200. And this one was $19 I paid for it, and I had a $5 off from Goodwill that I used. So it came up to be, I calculated everything. So I decided to just, if I picked something in terms of higher price, I'll deduct that $5 from that particular product. And this product was the most expensive from everything I got today. So it was $19.59, and I just deducted $5 from it. So it's $14, basically. It came up to be $14. It was $5 off. And it's in excellent condition. There are some minor scratch marks, cosmetic wear, but I disclosed it. I already listed it on eBay. So I tested it. Everything works, all the buttons work. I put the disc in, it plays. I even checked the headphone jack here, and it also works. I checked, connected it to speakers that I have, they work. I mean, it works with the speakers. So everything, I fully tested it before listing it. It took some time today when I came home to just decided to do that and list it today. And I listed it for $200. So I hope it's gonna bring, could have listed it for more maybe, but I checked the comps. It's there are only like one seller in the United States that has it, listed, and there are other two in Japan, and they are listed for almost like $500. But they have original box, remote control, cables, and manual. Mine just the unit, it will have a power cable. That's it. That's power cord from it. And no remote control, so last one without remote sold for $200 with free shipping. So I listed it for that price for $200. So guys, basically that's a haul today. You will see from footage I checked, there was a Panasonic DVD VCR combo that you will see me pick up, and I'll test it later thoroughly in Goodwill, because I actually got a VHS tape which they had to test it, and I tested it and it didn't work. The VHS it actually started pulling the tape inside, and that's a sign of either one of the, well, I know what it is, but I'm not sure. I forgot what it's called. It's like a pulley or roller. It's not working properly. It pulls the tape improperly. So I could have gotten it for, it was $11, as you saw me show it in Goodwill while I was there. But I mean, maybe I could have talked to the manager and gotten it for maybe $5 and just sold it. I took it to my friend, then he would fix it, you know. But they didn't have remote. So, and they, on eBay, that particular model was selling for around $39.99 plus shipping. There was one comp $49.99 with free shipping, I saw. And on Amazon, it actually goes for over $100. So, It's very important, guys. Whenever you see those DVD-VCR combos, if they're actually working and there is a remote control with it, you can make great money on Amazon selling them compared to eBay. Much like you're gonna double your money compared to selling it on eBay. So I usually list those things on either both platforms for higher price if I have remote control and all the cables, because it's important. Because if you list something like this on Amazon without the remote, manual, or I mean without just a remote, you're gonna have an issue because the buyer will return it to you. On eBay, it's a little bit different. You will put it in the description. The buyer will actually read the description, hopefully, and they will see there is no remote control. But the price, of course, will not be the same. I mean, it's gonna be like $39.99 plus shipping compared to if you have the remote. You would have listed it for like $69.99 was plus shipping. So that's a difference, a big difference in terms of having a remote or not having it. But I checked for the remote for this model, it was selling on eBay for almost $40. So, I mean, it would be no point to pay $11 plus $35. That's what I think was the last remote that sold for the $35 plus shipping. So you're looking at almost $50 investment into this DVD-VCR combo with remote control. So it didn't even make sense to put it on eBay at that point. So if I would have gotten it and gotten the remote, got it fixed, then I would have listed it on Amazon for $120. So that's the difference in terms of having remote or not having it, and make sure it's tested properly, you know, it works. So guys, I'll finish this vlog for today. Thanks for watching once again. I really appreciate you, whoever already subscribed to my channel. Really appreciate it, guys, and I'll be posting more videos. Sorry I don't post them regularly as I should, but I'm just don't have time to edit stuff and trying my best to do all the things that I do and then put up those YouTube videos. It's hard work, guys, believe me. So everyone who does YouTube knows that it's really hard to actually do it almost on every occasion, to edit stuff and put the videos up, cut some stuff and from the videos. It kind of takes hours sometimes, like a couple of hours, 3 hours. So you have to dedicate like almost half of your day to this kind of YouTube work, you know. But anyway, I'll put up more videos for you guys. So please, if you like this content, like, share and subscribe and hit that bell for notification. And I really appreciate you watching, guys. Stay safe and God bless.